In a game of gladiators, Ray Lewis was perhaps the most feared and respected, the epitome of leadership and the heart and soul of the Baltimore Ravens for decades. Today, we're going to take a look at just how good Ray Lewis was, actually. Raymond Jenkins was born in Bartow, Florida. Yeah, you heard that right, Raymond Jenkins. His mother was just 16 when he was born, and his father was incarcerated for most of his life. A young Ray became the father figure of the house for his five siblings. That passion for family and disgust for his father's lack of value in it led him to change his last name to Lewis, name of his mother's boyfriend. When every corner of Lakeland, Florida, the town he grew up in, crawled with criminals, it was Lewis's main goal to get his mother out of there, to take care of her, and that motivated him to stay away from the streets. As a kid, his competitive drive in neighborhood football games under streetlights led him to be a dominant player underneath the Friday night lights as well. As a sophomore in high school, he got on the field mid-season and never looked back, playing safety, as he was considered too small to be a linebacker, a claim that followed him throughout his career. Lewis only knew one speed on the field, full go. And that served him well as he played on both sides of the ball as a senior, running the rock on offense and running sideline to sideline as a backer on defense. As rare as a talent as there was, Lewis overcame his small size with intensity and instincts, becoming an All-American linebacker and a state champion wrestler on top of that. After Florida State, his dream school, chose someone else over him, Ray was actually the very last recipient of a scholarship to the University of Miami in 1993. With a team as dominant as the Miami Hurricanes were in the 90s, freshmen didn't typically see the field. Well, unless that freshman is Ray Lewis. Canes officials told him he wouldn't play early on, and he wasn't even included in the media guide. Lewis didn't need a fire lit, but now he had one. He was inserted into a Week 3 game against Colorado due to injury and had 17 tackles to help Miami win a 35-29 thriller on his debut. He played every game for the remainder of his college career, and he finished his freshman year as a starter for the final five games and being named to the freshman All-American team. As a sophomore, he led the Big East with 152 tackles, breaking the Canes' single-season tackle record, and was named an All-American. As a junior, he eclipsed that by breaking his own record with 160 tackles, leading the number one defense in the nation and falling just short of a national championship. Ray Lewis's time at the U was historic, but the NFL was calling and he was listening. He passed up his senior year to enter the 1996 NFL draft. It would be insane to have the first two draft picks in your franchise's existence be Hall of Famers. Well, that's exactly what the inaugural Baltimore Ravens did when they selected Jonathan Ogden and Ray Lewis in the first round. With the fourth overall pick, they took Ogden. With the 26th overall pick, they took Ray. Many scouts loved Lewis, but hated his lack of size, saying it would limit his potential. Boy, were they wrong. In his first game, with no leaders on the field and a complete lack of talent around him with the upstart Ravens, Ray Lewis took the reins immediately. He was already the heart and soul of the Baltimore Ravens in his NFL debut. Against the Oakland Raiders, Lewis and his legendary purple number 52 were all over the field. He finished with 7 tackles and stole a pick right off of a Raiders hands. That interception sealed the first win in Ravens history, and it was only right it was due to the play of Ray Lewis. The remainder of the 96 season was a struggle for the Ravens, but Ray shined through. The young Ravens finished 4-12, while Lewis finished the season with 100-plus tackles, 15 for loss, 2 sacks, and a nomination to the NFL All-Rookie team. In 97, just his second year in the league, Lewis cemented himself as the premier linebacker in football. He recorded 184 tackles and a still-standing NFL record of 156 solo tackles. The Ravens improved into a middle-of-the-pack team where they would stay for the next 2 years. While Lewis was an absolute force, making 3 straight Pro Bowls from 97 to 99 and leading the league in tackles in 97 and 99. Then, the year 2000. Ray was always the best player on the field, and he made the players around him better. He brought out their passion and raised their play, Rex Ryan, longtime NFL coach, said of Lewis. And 2000 was the symbol of everything Ray Lewis stood for. The Ravens were loaded on defense, with Rod Woodson, Chris McAllister, and Dwayne Starks in the secondary, Sam Adams and Tony Siragusa clogging up the middle, Peter Boulware and Rob Burnett on the edge, and of course, their leader, Ray Lewis, inspiring this special group. What they did is considered arguably the greatest defensive season in NFL history. Firstly, they forced 49 turnovers in 16 games. The Ravens opened the season up, forcing 3 shutouts in the first 6 games, on the way to a 5-1 record. The Lewis-led defense kept the Ravens in every game, including winning 2, when the offense was kept out of the end zone for 5 straight games. 5 straight! They had no help at all from their offensive counterpart, yet they still held opposing offenses to the lowest amount of points allowed in 16-game schedule history. They averaged just 10 points allowed per game and finished with 4 shutouts, just one shy of the Steel Curtain's 1976 record. Running the ball on them? Forget about it. They are the only team ever to hold opponents under 1,000 rushing yards over an entire season. Ray Lewis, with 137 tackles, 2 interceptions, and 3 fumble recoveries, won NFL Defensive Player of the Year. But the year became even more special in the playoffs. They suffocated the AFC, allowing just one touchdown in their first 3 playoff games, all while being wild-card road warriors. In the rubber match with the Titans in the divisional round, it was Lewis's clutch 50-yard interception TD that sealed the game. They met the Giants in Super Bowl 35, where Lewis and the Ravens defense put together one of the most dominant performances we've ever seen. They completely shut down the Giants and scored more points on defense than the Giants could on offense. It ended up with a 34-7 victory, in which Ray Lewis was named Super Bowl MVP. It was the storybook script that Lewis dreamed of, from a dirt-poor Lakeland kid to Super Bowl MVP. The biggest thing he became known for, other than his fiery passion, came the next season. In an effort to fire up the 0-1 Ravens, Ray Lewis decided to bring a dance created by childhood friend Kirby Lee to life, and the Squirrel Dance was born. Hot in Here by Nelly hits the stadium PA, and the NFL's most vicious gladiator bursts out of the tunnel screaming and sliding from left to right. The dance was meant to give a spark, and it turned into a battle cry. It ignited the fans. It pumped up his Ravens teammates. Even opponents made sure to watch Ray Lewis dance. It meant they were about to lace it up for 60 minutes with one of the greatest to ever do it. The Ravens finished the 2001 season with a 10-6 record, and Lewis was named to his 5th straight Pro Bowl and 3rd straight first-team All-Pro. The Ravens beat the Dolphins in the wild-card round before eventually losing to a divisional round matchup with the Steelers. Lewis's 2002 season was derailed due to injury, and the Ravens struggled without their leader, going 7-9 on the year. In 2003, he won his 2nd Defensive Player of the Year award, and the Ravens got back on track, making the playoffs again, though they were bounced in the first round by the Titans. 2004 was more of the same for Ray, another first-team All-Pro season, and we think Lewis inspired Madden to create the hit stick when he graced the cover of Madden 2005. Unfortunately, Ray was not immune to the Madden curse, as his 2005 season was cut short due to injury. In 2006, Lewis banded together another great set of players on the Ravens' stingy defense, including Terrell Suggs, Bart Scott, and another emerging superstar for the Ravens in safety Ed Reed. After leading the league in every defensive category, Lewis and the Ravens met their ultimate rival in the playoffs, the league's best offense in Peyton Manning and the Colts. Lewis shut down the game's most prolific passer, keeping the Colts out of the end zone, but it didn't matter as they fell short to the eventual Super Bowl champions 15-6. While Ray Lewis continued his great form in 2007, being selected for another Pro Bowl, the Ravens struggled. However, in 2008, they returned to dominance under a new head coach, John Harbaugh. Ray Lewis made the first All-Pro team again for the first time since 2004, and the Ravens made a deep playoff run, falling moments short of the Super Bowl with a loss to the Steelers in the conference championship. This led to another moment that would help cement Lewis's legacy. That offseason, Ray Lewis would be a free agent for the first time in his career. Courted by the Cowboys and the Chargers, it took all of 10 days for Lewis to realize, "I couldn't be anywhere else. This is me. It's not about the money, it's more about the legacy. I think it was a true recipe for leadership to go down with the ship. Through all our down years, making sure my city knows, I'll be here forever." Ray Lewis was a Raven, more than anybody else was. He exemplified their franchise and refused to play anywhere else as he signed a 7-year, $44.5 million contract, very much a hometown discount. Though he didn't know it at the time that his loyalty would be rewarded. To be expected, Lewis outplayed that contract, averaging over 100 tackles and making the Pro Bowl for each of the next 3 seasons, including his final All-Pro nod in 2009. But the Ravens just could not get over the hump in the playoffs, losing twice in the divisional round and once in the conference championship in 2011. Now a 17-year vet, Lewis missed 10 games in 2012 with 2 torn triceps. He didn't have much left in the tank. He came back for the playoffs when no one expected he would, then made an announcement that no one expected. This would be his last ride. In what would be Ray's final home game, the Ravens beat the Colts 24-9 in the wild card round. On the last play, Lewis lined up in victory and led the crowd in one last squirrel dance routine. The crowd went wild. You could feel the goosebumps through the TV. Then, the Ravens did what no one expected. They went on a run. It would take a miracle. A mile-high miracle. Down by 7, Joe Flacco threw up a prayer. It was answered by Jacoby Jones streaking down the field for a game-tying 70-yard touchdown. Lewis then captained 2 shutdown overtime periods over his arch-rival Peyton Manning to beat the Broncos in double overtime. The next week, the Ravens throttled Tom Brady's Patriots in the AFC Championship game, avenging their last 2 postseason losses. In the same game, Lewis re-aggravated his torn triceps. But if you thought that was keeping Ray Lewis out of Super Bowl Episode 47, you haven't been listening. It was his last ride, and he was going out on his shield. In the Super Bowl, the Ravens dominated to start the game, jumping out to a 28-6 lead. Then, after a strange power outage, the Niners came surging back to make it a one-score game. It all came down to one last play. It would take one last heroic goal line stand. The Ravens sent the house as Colin Kaepernick lofted a ball into the end zone. After being in the air for what felt like an eternity, that ball fell harmlessly to the ground. Ray Lewis would go out a Super Bowl champion. After 17 years, Lewis retired the only 2,000 tackle player in NFL history and the NFL record holder with over 1,500 solo tackles. He went to the Pro Bowl in three different decades, 13 times in total, and made seven first All-Pro teams. His 31 interceptions is top five all-time among linebackers. He won two NFL Defensive Player of the Year awards, becoming just one of eight players to ever accomplish the feat. Just 4 years after his playing days ended, he got the call. He was a unanimous first ballot Hall of Famer. How good was Ray Lewis actually? He's the greatest Raven to ever live, the greatest middle linebacker to ever live, and more importantly, the greatest leader to ever play the game.